Hey and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. It's been a while since I was able to upload, so apologies for all that. I've been working on a few different projects. One of them was where I had to remove a person from a movie clip. So I thought I'd share with you guys how I did that, and maybe it can help you for your projects. So the first thing we need to do is change this from the 3D view to the movie clip editor, and then we can go ahead and load in our movie clip. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to use this movie clip too. Okay, so we can set the resolution as well if we need to, and also the frame rate. And then we can set the movie length. So if we select this button here, this set scene frames, it will set the end frame for us. So if we hit prefetch as well, this will prefetch the movie clip. If for some reason it doesn't prefetch all the way through, what you can do is go to File, then User Preferences, System, and scroll down. You just want to increase this memory cache limit. Now it doesn't have to be the maximum, but it just needs to be more than what you already have it at now. Then if we hit save user settings, we don't need to worry about it again. And there we go. So this footage we have here is, it's a lighthouse with some guy just, I don't know, he's either exercising or praying to the ocean god or something, I don't know. But we don't want him in the scene. So what we can do is just mask him out, which is very easy to do. And again, we've done something similar to this in other tutorials. It's pretty simple to do. So press T and N to get rid of the sidebars if you want more space. Let's change this to the masking mode. And if you've added masks before, you already know how to do this. You just press Control and left click to add a point. And just keep Control left clicking around. We just want to make a basic shape like this. And this is going to be one of the first masks we create. We're going to create a couple more as well. Press Alt C to close the mask. And then what we want to do is scrub through this footage and make sure the hands don't go outside the mask. Like they go out here, so we need to just reposition this a bit. Like so. Move this, maybe this one here. And this one. And again, scrub through, make sure they don't go outside the mask, otherwise the effect will be ruined. So just scrub through and then reposition it. That looks fine. So now you have this, we can, well, first let's name this, since we're going to have a couple more masks, it's nice to know what they do. I'm just going to name this Man. Now we can go over to the node editor. And what we need to do is change this to the scene tab. We want to check use nodes. So we have these two nodes here. And we also want to check backdrop so we can see what we're doing. Okay, so we need this composite node, this is what's going to be rendered out, but we don't need this render layer, so let's press X and delete that. Shift A, let's go to Import. We want to import a movie clip. What we can do is just connect this up, this image to the image. Okay, we also want to, instead of pressing Open, what we can do is press this icon here, since we already have the movie clip loaded in, just select it. Now we see the preview down here, but we don't see a backdrop, so we need to add another node. So Shift A, go to Output, then add a viewer node. I'm just going to delete that one. What you can do is, if you have the node Wrangler add-on enabled, you can press Control Shift and left click on any node and it will show you the preview of it. So it's just a lazy way of adding a viewer node, I guess. Okay, so now that's done, what we can do is get rid of this guy here. So let's Shift A, go to Color, and then mix. We can place this on the bottom string here and then just connect this to the viewer. Just make a little bit of space. Take this and plug this into here, like so. Shift A, go to Input, add in a mask. Let's place this up here. I'm going to select this icon and choose the mask. And then plug this into the factor. So nothing's changed, or at least it doesn't look like it has, but we do have something going on. If we hit Shift A, add in a translate node, and we want to put this on the bottom string, like so. We want to move it on the X, so it's left and right. We just want to move him out the way. So I'm just going to keep moving this until we no longer see him. So you want to make sure you don't see him and you don't see the edge of the frame either, so that's okay. The next thing we need to do is get rid of that harsh line, so Shift A, add in a blur. And if I zoom in so you can see this a little bit better, it might be hard for you to see, but I mean you can clearly see the harsh line, but we just move this over, we'll see how much the blur helps. So we just increase this now. We can see that the blur helps a lot. How much blur you use is entirely up to you. You might want to use something around 80, 90, 100. So it all depends on the scene that you're working with and the size of the mask. And now we're only focused on the water and the sky. The rock itself, we're going to add in another mask to sort that out, so we don't need to worry about that. But we can see it blends in quite nicely. Again, you can play around with the values, get something a bit better. But I think that looks good for now. So if we play through this, see how it looks. The waves look okay. So this is before and after. Looks pretty good. So we need to now replace that rock or bring it back in. So let's jump back over to the movie clip editor. And then what we need to do is create a new mask for this rock here. So let's go down here, press the plus button. Let's rename this rock. And again, let's add a new mask. I'm going to trace around this shape. So control left click. And Alt-C to close the mask. And then let's jump back over to the node editor. And then let's add this rock back into the scene, so it's pretty easy to do. Let's just move these out of the way. So let's go to color, then mix. Plug this in here. And we want to take the original feed, so this original here, plug this into the bottom. And then Shift A, let's add in a mask. Let's go to input and then mask. I guess I could have duplicated the other mask there, but I don't know. Let's just add in a new one. Let's connect this up to the factor. We need to change this to the rock mask. And it's not updated, so I'm just going to press Shift, Control, and click so it just updates it. I don't know why it does that. But yeah, if you don't see it changed, make sure you just plug this back into the viewer node again. So you can see it needs a little bit of work. We need to refine the edges. And also get rid of the feet, so we're going to add another mask just to get rid of the feet. But for now we're just going to refine these edges. So we can add in a blur, if we go to filter, then blur. And we can add this to the mask string, so where it's connected to the factor. Apologies if this is all jumbled and messed up. So let's just increase this to around 10, maybe that's too much. Let's just reduce this a little bit. Maybe 5. That looks pretty natural. So that looks good, and maybe we need to change the mask as well. We need to get a little bit tighter to the edge, so back over to the movie clip editor. We just want to drag these closer to the edge. And this here as well. Just so it looks a little bit better. Jump back over to the node editor, see how it looks. Yeah, it looks a little bit better now. So now we need to get rid of the feet, which is pretty simple, and it's just like what we did with the man. So let's just add a new mask. Down here, press the plus button, and let's rename this feet. Let's add a new mask. We just want to make a little oval shape, I guess. Just to get rid of the feet here. Press Alt-C to close the mask. Jump back over to the node editor. So it's pretty much the same technique we did before. Just drag these out. Shift A, go to color, then mix. Plug this in. And we want to take the original feed again. But if we have the node wrangler add-on, we can hold shift and then draw a line here to create a reroute node. But again, you can just select the original if you want. That's entirely up to you. It's just to make things a little bit tidier, just add a reroute node. Shift D and let's duplicate this mask. Plug this in here. We definitely want to change the mask to the feet. So we need to shift A. We want to go down to distort and then add a translate node and plug this in here because we want to translate that feet. We don't want to move it on the X, which is left and right. If we do that, we'll probably end up with the water. So we want to change that back to zero and we want to move it on the Y. Something like this is fine, even though it's the wrong color, it doesn't matter. We're going to change that in a second. Shift A, let's add a filter and blur. Just needs blurring a bit on the mask. Again, we could have duplicated this one, but why not add a new one? So let's change this to something small. Maybe a bit more. Maybe a bit too much. So maybe 5x5, let's try that. That looks okay. So now we just want to change the color, make it look a bit more natural. So Shift A, go to color, then to RGB curves and plug this in here. And let's just slowly increase this till we match the rock. It'll take a while to update as well because we've got a few nodes working as well. So give it a moment. So I think that works. If we just zoom out, if we just find it. So again, that looks a lot better than what it did before. And we've got rid of the man, we've also replaced the rock and got rid of the feet. Once we've had some colour correction onto it as well, it'll look a lot better. So again, you might want to go back to the first blur node and change and play around with this one, depending on how it blends into the rest of the scene. So just play around these values until you get something that works for you. So now that's done, you can add some colour grading. So stretch these out and add in your colour grading. And then let's change the file type to H.264. Let's also set the file output. Make sure the resolution and the frame rate is correct. And then you can go ahead and hit animate. So I hope this tutorial helped. If it did, be sure to give it a like. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time.